Change. It's happening all around us. It demands more of us. But we never settle for just good enough. Changes in the commercial and industrial world, like rising transportation costs, pressure to increase productivity and reduce energy use, and an aging workforce, take on a whole new meaning when you add the logistics of handling a massive increase in online shopping. Now, if that sounds like a lot, you're right. It makes you want to take the easy way out, right? Well, in this case, we agree with you. You see, we've come up with a way to automate your processes simply without giving up functionality. An innovation that's small, yet feature-rich and bulletproof. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Eaton's PowerXL DM1 Micro Variable Frequency Drive. The PowerXL DM1 has both variable and constant torque ratings, as well as active energy control. These built-in features work together to reduce your system's energy consumption by up to 10% more than a standard drive. Efficient, right? Further, this robust micro VFD was designed with safety in mind. It's the first VFD available that can use fuses, circuit breakers, or Type E manual motor protectors for short circuit protection up to 65 kA. Now that's something to talk about. We made the PowerXL DM1 easy to operate from anywhere. This flexible device is perfect for facilities that rely on browser-based controls and facilities that prefer storing files on local hard drives. It can be set up with an Ethernet cable and connect via Bluetooth for direct IoT connectivity. Or it can be controlled, programmed, and commissioned with Eaton's PowerXpert in Control software. Both methods are safe and secure, and neither requires proprietary cables. We call the DM1 the little juggernaut, and that's because it offers a full spectrum of connectivity options and wide-ranging control flexibility. All of this built in to a single small device. So, as you can see, Eaton's PowerXL DM1 offers the capabilities that you demand in one easy to operate device. Demand more than good enough. Demand Eaton variable frequency drives. Welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, Eaton Nation. I'm Josh Kingsley, your host for All Things Control by Eaton. I want to welcome everybody to a very special Ask the Expert event as we reveal our latest innovation, the PowerXL DM1 Micro Variable Frequency Drive. Now, we're going to be taking a different approach to this Ask the Expert session in that our guests will be using the Microsoft HoloLens to showcase some of DM1's unique features. So let's meet our presenters for today. First, please say hello to our product manager for the PowerXL DM1, Mr. Raj Narayanan.
Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening.
Howdy, Raj. Glad to have you on here. And also sporting the HoloLens, as promised, our global product line manager for variable frequency drives. Please welcome Mr. Charles Tahara.
Everybody, thank you very much for joining. Appreciate your time and really looking forward to today.
All right. Welcome, gentlemen. Glad to have you guys on here. So let's get some housekeeping out of the way. For you guys, our audience, you can ask questions via the comment sections below on LinkedIn or Facebook. And as an added bonus, you can download a free application note that explains how DM1 helps you achieve permanent magnet synchronous motor control. Now, we're going to show you how to do that at the conclusion of this presentation, so make sure that you stick with us all the way to the end.
And this Ask the Expert session is brought to you by the PowerXL DM1 Micro Variable Frequency Drive. Please visit eaton.com/DM1 to learn more about this new innovation. And once again, that is eaton.com/DM1. And I think we can jump right in and start to explore this product. And I'm already seeing all kinds of questions come up. So let's start with, from our LinkedIn platform, we have a question from Najeev. And Najeev asks, what are the overall features and benefits of the DM1 VFD? And Charles, I want to start with you on this one.
Awesome. Appreciate that, Josh. And Najeev, thank you for the question. It's actually a fantastic opportunity to use the HoloLens. So if you guys just give me a second, I'm going to go ahead and get connected here. Pardon me while we switch the stream over. All right, so up in front of me through the HoloLens eyes over here, I have our DM1 Frame 1 Pro model. So pretty excited. I want to show you guys a couple of things today. First and foremost, this is a full-fledged VFD product. It's dual-rated, both constant torque and variable torque. It has a built-in brake chopper and a bunch of other features that I'm going to unpack here in just a second. But in order to do that, I'm going to use this handy-dandy tool here. I'm going to blow this up. And you can kind of see what the guts of this thing look like. Now, most of you probably won't get into this, but I'm going to use this to show some of the features of it. So all DM1 products, both the basic and the pro models, have a couple of features that we've included. First and foremost, you can kind of see towards the back there, the line side MOVs. That's what's going to help us with some rudimentary surge protection. Right above it, you can see the two screws are the MOV and the EMI screws, so they are field removable and reinstallable. So if you're ordering this product, you're not sure which one to stock, but you want to kind of cover all your bases, and then you all of a sudden have to disable the EMI for an IT corner grounded system, you can just remove that screw that's in the far left there. The other thing that's kind of slick about this product in particular is how compact we made it. So I'm going to use my handy dandy little swivel tool here for just a second. Let's see if I can grab it. Unfortunately, I will admit I am pretty new to this whole HoloLens thing, so just bear with me. There it goes. So I'm going to dive in here and just on the inside. Kind of cool about the design of this particular product is we spent a lot of time on the cooling channel for this. So it's a very, very, very compact cooling channel, cooling off that primary IGBT section. And then you can see the fan up there, kind of a nice perk to this overall is that the fan is actually programmable. So through the parameters, you can decide whether you want it to be on all the time or if you want it to be based on the internal temperature of the drive or if you want it to be on only at certain times to try to dampen the noise. So there's a lot of flexibility in how you apply this product overall and a lot of the considerations for acoustic noise and other things as well. So pretty slick. And now I'm going to switch back to the keypad view here. Tell you what, there you go. All right, it's not letting me grab it for some reason, probably because we are live, but we'll just roll with it. Another thing that's really nice about how the keypad itself is structured, so you're gonna have your cover over here, and I'll reset that later to show that, of course, the grabs now. One of the things that's slick about it is how dense and how we were able to pack all the I/O in here. So on the front side, you can see where the keypad, remote keypad is going to plug into, as well as where your Ethernet-based comms are based. You have your SafeTorque off terminals underneath the hood as well, and then a whole plethora of I/O and relay inputs and outputs. So just overall, a really, really cool, very compact design. I'm going to go ahead and reset the model now. And then now that we've kind of got it back all together, I can talk about just some of the distinguishing features between the basic and the pro model. So the basic unit is without the keypad, without the speed potentiometer, no Ethernet, no STO. But the pro model has this nice keypad that you can see here. It is a full user interface, so you can navigate through all the parameter structures, your start stop, you know, changing your reference, as well as a speed potentiometer. And then, like I mentioned before, underneath the hood, you have your safe torque off, you have your Ethernet-based comms, and then your keypad connection. So, you know, really, really slick. There's a lot to this design. We're very proud of it. Yeah, it has a ton, a whole host of features. So appreciate the question, Najeev. And Josh, I'm turning it back to you here.
Okay, yeah, Charles, that's awesome. That's a ton of built-in features. And I mean, I personally didn't realize how fully loaded this little device really was. And I completely understand why we're calling it the little juggernaut.
And I do actually have one more point to chime in with, Josh, if that's okay.
Yeah, for sure. Go for it.
So one thing that is kind of slick about it is it also features a lot from the part number structure standpoint. You're allowed to basically order what you need. So if you want to go for that basic model without an EMI filter because you're really trying to drive all the cost out of the device, we have part numbers set up for that. Those are also going to be stocked in our warehouse. If you want kind of the full-fledged thing for your warehouse stock because you're trying to make sure you can cover whatever it is that life throws at you, and you want those MRO opportunities, we do have the full-fledged models and part numbers as well. And we even have regional ordering codes. So if you have customers that need defaults set up for voltage in APAC versus in Europe or in the Americas, we have region codes you can add to get those defaults preset.
That's awesome, Charles. Gotta love all the options that you put together in there. And it sounds like you really thought through how this product should be put together and put out in front for the market. So thank you very much. And really hope that answered your question, Najeev. Pretty long answer, but it was great to see the HoloLens at work as well. All right, so let's get into the next question. And I'm going to stay on LinkedIn here. And this one's going to come in from Paula. And so her question is, how can DM1 save energy for AC motor control applications? And Raj, I believe this one is going to be perfect for you.
Indeed, indeed it is, Josh. Hey, Paula, nice meeting with you. VFDs in general are very energy efficient compared to the other traditional speed control methods, such as, you know, DC drives or across the line starters. And the real energy savings is, you know, possible in variable torque applications such as fans or pumps, where the energy consumed increases as the cubic relation to the motor speed and vice versa. There is a tremendous opportunity to save energy when these motors run at lower speeds. And of course, you know, apart from the energy savings, our PowerXL drives, including these DM1s, they come with a standard energy optimization algorithm called active energy control. And with this active energy control, users could experience an additional up to 10% of energy savings compared to the other traditional VFDs in the market.
10% energy savings, did I hear that correctly?
Yes, Josh, up to 10% more. And not only that, these drives come with a real-time clock and also an energy savings calculator built in. So the users can anytime look at how much energy their drive has saved. And usually the return of investment is less than 2 years, between 1 and 2 years.
That's great. That's incredible. So you not only get your savings, but you can actually see them in real time as you're operating your device. That's great. Thank you very much, Raj. And I really hope that answers your question as well, Paula. All right, so I am going to jump over to the Facebook platform for this one. And this is a good one. So tell me more about the safety features in the DM1. And this one's coming from Harrison on Facebook. So once again, tell me more about the safety features in the DM1.
So I can take that one, Josh. And thanks, Harrison, for the question. So it's pretty exciting. So the DM1 is designed to ensure that your personnel and your equipment are safe. The first thing I'm going to talk about is the safe torque off feature. So this meets the specification defined by EN 6204-1 It is a globally accepted standard. And in the case of like the rating that we meet the DM1 to the SIL 2 rating. So what it does is it's going to prevent power from being applied to the motor when a safety interlock or a light curtain or a safety gate or some kind of e-stop command is issued to the drive. VFDs that don't have that SIL 2 rating and where their machines are required to perform at that level are going to need additional output contactors, a safety relay, all that sort of stuff. So in a way, we're basically reducing the system cost while giving you a higher level of safety performance. The next thing that I want to talk about is the Bluetooth portion, which typically we don't associate, you know, safety and Bluetooth. But one of the things that's nice about it is because it has the ability to connect remotely. When you have an enclosed panel door, or if you're got the drive buried inside of a machine, you can actually connect directly to that device. Now there are layers of protection, so you can avoid any kind of issues or tampering. But you can connect remotely to that device, and then you don't have to open up that door, throw your arc flash gear on, et cetera.
That built-in Bluetooth feature is pretty awesome, Charles, but I do want to make sure that I apologize on behalf of Eaton that all our MRO folks are not going to have to be putting that arc flash suit on again. I know how much everybody loves putting on that heavy PPE gear to get into a panel. So that Bluetooth feature is awesome. And Harrison, I really hope that answers your question. And man, we're getting blown up. These questions are coming in fast and furious, but the producers are reminding me that I do need to remind you that we have a free application note available for you. It is going to cover the topic of permanent magnet synchronous motor control, and we are going to make this available to you at the end of the presentation. So please do stick with us. We are going to get to the end, and we'll get that info to you. So let's get to the next question. All right. So this next one is going to come from LinkedIn again, and this one's from Maggie, and she wants us to explain how IIoT functionality in VFDs. So explain IIoT functionality in VFDs, and the follow-up to that is, how is the industry evolving? And Raj, I believe this is going to be a good one for you to talk about.
Yeah, that's a great question, Maggie. Thank you very much for being on the call. And we are in the industry 4.0 age, where the connectivity and remote monitoring and control are the trends of future trends in automation. The industrial Internet of Things is becoming very widely popular in several applications that, you know, and you know, our DM1 VFDs are geared for that. We have, you know, control, not only remote monitoring, but also control and preventive maintenance, everything making it possible by, you know, having this IoT feature available on these VFDs. Yeah, it is a great thing, and you know, we are looking at the future, and we are gearing up our product to meet the future trends.
Okay, so quick follow-up question for me. So we know about IIoT, but does this DM1 also have IoT capabilities, Raj?
Yes, DM1s are built in with the IoT capabilities, where you can exchange, it can push the information to the cloud, wherein the customers can monitor not only the health of the VFDs, but also of the connected equipment.
Gotcha, that's great. Well, that would definitely give me peace of mind, and I hope that all of our viewers are feeling the same. So let's get to another question. And this one is another two-parter, and I'm gonna pull this from Facebook from Mario. And so the first half of this question is, why are short circuit current ratings important? And then the second half of this is, what are the short circuit current protection ratings of a DM1? Charles, you talked about safety earlier, so I think we can have you expand upon that for this one.
Yeah, absolutely, Josh. Happy to, and thank you for the question too, Mario. So typically in a plant, you'll have a VFD that's taking its line side feed from a large transformer. If there's an issue in the power circuit, you may have several thousand amps of short circuit power flow through that through that short circuit area, which could create an event. If the circuit is left unprotected, that could result in an arc flash or explosion or a fire. People can get hurt in some situations. Equipment can get damaged. So it's just a bad news all the way around. The nice thing about the DM1 in particular, even amongst its peers, is that it can deliver very, very high levels of short circuit protection, but it also can do so not only with fuses. So it delivers short circuit ratings or SCCR ratings, not only with fuses, but with molded case circuit breakers, Type E manual motor protectors, and miniature circuit breakers, all under the new UL standard. With breakers and fuses, we can even hit levels like 100 KA.
Okay, so wait, you talked about the new UL standard, and by that I assume you're meaning the 61800-5-1. Are you telling me that, one, you're achieving this, that, two, the DM1 is the first VFD to do that?
Yep, exactly. We're the first to be to have an offering out there, not only with the fuses, but offering those resettable forms of circuit protection.
All right, that's great. And that's a great accomplishment. Really happy that you are able to get that into the DM1, and the implication that this little guy can ultimately help customers reduce their overall costs. So this is awesome. I like it. I know our audience likes it, and I hope that answers your question, Mario.
Thanks, Mario.
All right, let's see what is next. So we're going to go with Kyle on LinkedIn. So is this product available in a high frequency model? And by high frequency, we mean 800 hertz or higher. So Raj, I'll let you field this one.
Yeah, we have this product available up to 400 hertz at this point. And you know, we are continuously evolving, and this drive can control motors at this point up to 400 hertz.
Okay, perfect. So let's go with our next question. This one is also coming from LinkedIn. It looks like that's where we're getting most of our audience today. So Mike on LinkedIn has a question. How hardened is the unit to capacitor switching transients?
So just to be clear on, I can jump in here, but just to be clear on the type of transients that we're talking about, right? If we're talking about line side transients, we do have front end MOVs on the line side. So you'll see a little bit of that kind of protection. If you're in an area where you're getting a lot of storms or circuit events, we would still recommend having an external commercial grade surge protective device protecting your equipment overall. But this can withstand a limited amount of an event. Now, if you're talking about reflective wave transients going from the DC bus back on the line, this, like any other VFD, is going to be producing those harmonics. So I would say, you know, definitely look at the design of your situation, what the overall VFD-driven loads are for the facility you're in, or specifically coming from that downstream transformer. And if you need support, you know, figuring out what your harmonics look like at the point of common coupling for your application, we have a team of engineering service folks who can help with that site assessment as well.
Perfect. All right. So I'm going to stick with LinkedIn here. I'm going to jump over to Facebook for this one. Russell on Facebook has a question. So thinking of our 600 VAC systems in Canada, does the DM1 have a 660 VAC max or better? And Charles, tell me about that.
Yeah, I can jump in for that one as well. We actually are very fortunate that we are bringing the launch today, the full offering of the DM1. So we do have a 600 volt or 575 volt rated units. It does have a north end of, I think, about 660 volts. So Russell, definitely meeting that sweet spot that you're talking about for line voltage in Canada. But we also offer 480 three-phase, 230 three-phase, and then we also jump into our single-phase ratings. 120 volt single-phase, which is more of like your domestic power rating, or 230 volt single-phase if you're looking at light commercial. So we cross just about all of the voltages that you would see for this type of application.
Cool. Quick follow-up from Russell on Facebook. During the introduction, it talked about an SCCR rating of 65 KA, and I think we just want a little clarity. Is that at 480 or 600 VAC? Charles, you seem to be the safety guy,
yeah.
So let's go. Let's go with you on that.
Yeah, I'll answer that one as well. So actually, for 480 volt or 230 volt, with fuses or molded case breakers, we can do up to 100 KA with that. But the 65 KA is a reference to what we can do with our Type E manual motor protectors, which are more that IEC form factor MMP that we're used to seeing. Now, once you get into the 600 volt side of the ratings, I believe we do drop the breaker ratings down from 100 KA to 65 KA. Just a plug as well. I mean, these have been tested and qualified with our power defense, which is the next generation of multi-case circuit breakers. So, you know, really good, a really good comprehensive set of ratings there.
All right. Perfect. Thank you, Charles. I'm going to stay on Facebook here, have some new questions coming in. And Siraj, I'm going to ask you two questions real quick from Rob on Facebook. And so the first question is, can you do any PLC type of logic like was available in the MVX 9000? So let's do that one, and then I'll have a follow-up.
MVX, in this, you know, these DM1s, we can do custom text-based logic. It's still not a, you know, ladder logic, but you know, we can do for large opportunities. If someone wants a, you know, text-based, you know, some of the OEM customers, especially if they want a logic built in, we can help with the text-based logic in the near future. We can work on large opportunities and help that done in this DM1 drives. But for, you know, customer applied logic or in a customer built logic, we are not ready yet, but currently we can support the large opportunities with our, you know, logic engine, text base, program it and ship it.
Okay, so the next question, thanks for that, also from Rob on Facebook, any type of input filtering included, and if so, what percentage?
We have built-in EMC filters available that is an option. So you can order these drives, DM1 and DM1 Pro, with and without the EMC filters. And so it is the industrial standard, EN, the standard. I don't have it in front of me, but you know, you can order these drives with built-in EMC filters. It is, that option is available.
All right, and perfect. I just want to chime in there real quick, Josh, if I can. The other component too is going to be the line side filtering from a harmonic standpoint. So this does not feature a built-in DC choke. So if you're concerned again about the line side harmonics, we do have an offering of line and load side reactors that you can purchase with the DM1. And we offer both 3 and 5% rated line reactors, AC reactors, depending on your application. And if you need support figuring out what the right combination is of products, you know, we can absolutely help you, whether it's through our technical resource center or through our team of product line application engineers. So thanks for the question, Rob. Yeah, absolutely.
All right. And it looks like we're going to pause here and show a QR code on our screen. So I'll give that a moment to pop up. All right. So what I need everybody to do is open the camera on your smartphone or your tablet and point that camera towards the QR code. And it's gonna take you to where you can download the application note that we've mentioned a couple of times. So we're gonna leave this up for a moment. And so to get into a little more detail about how to do this, if you are in a position where you can scan by pulling up your smartphone camera or your tablet, you'll open up the camera, you'll point it at the QR code, and you're gonna have a pop-up populate at the very top of your screen. And it's gonna ask you if you wanna go to a web link, and you'll just click yes. And so if you cannot scan, there's gonna be a link at the end of this, and then it'll also be in the comments section here momentarily as well. We're gonna get that put there as well. And then you'll also be able to go back into the actual invitation. And after you fill out the simple form, it's got some information that you should know and have pretty readily available. We're mainly talking contact information type of things. You'll get an email where you'll be able to download the app note. All right, and we are gonna go ahead and post that code on the event page at the end of this broadcast. And so what I want to remind everybody again is to learn more about the product, please visit eaton.com/DM1. And once again, that is eaton.com/DM1. And so I want to go ahead at this point and thank Charles and Raj for joining us.
Hey, thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you bet.
Josh, thank you very much for hosting this.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And again, thank you to our viewers for tuning in. You're what makes all these events great and makes it worth doing. So make sure you join us again next month for another edition of Ask the Expert Live. And good day.